Hey folks, I think I'm going to do an Andy Mooseman video. For those of you that don't know him, Andy has put up some videos of just vlogging, talking, wherever it takes him. It's kind of interesting. Done a lot of introspection in the last couple of days, some really kind of deep thinking about my experiences out here on YouTube. What am I trying to accomplish? I just got off the phone with someone that I hadn't expected to get a phone call from, and I don't really know them, but they brought to light, I'm the kind of person that feels that I can learn something from anyone, even people I don't like, and that everyone in the world has some value. That one's been sorely tested lately. I definitely have to tell you that. But we were having a conversation about this particular situation that I'm in. And he said, this is a fight that you can't win. I said, what do you mean it's a fight I can't win? To begin with, I don't really want to fight. I'm just there. He said, because you're not willing to take it to the level that these people would take it. He said, you're too good of a person to do that. I hate it when other people know more about me than I do. And then he said, well, you know, what do you expect to get out of this? Without even thinking, it came out. Well, I think people should be held accountable for how they treat other people in the world. Kind of some silence on the other end of the line, and I realized when I said it how god-awful naive that must sound. I want people to be held accountable in the world for what they do. In this world, I want people to be held accountable. Good Lord, where the hell do I think I'm living? I don't know. I've really thought about this a lot, you know. The whole thing when I started out here on YouTube and responding to other people, and some people have, you know, I've talked to people a lot about YouTube experiences and what we do out here and why we do what we do, and I started to really, in the last couple of weeks, really do some introspection. And thinking about, I was reading a book, I'm not going to remember the name of it now, but it's a book about how we're scripted from when we're children, and those scripts get played out as we grow older. And the script for me from childhood is not great. I mean, I don't talk much about my childhood, but my parents were pretty much missing in action most of the time. I was pretty much raised by my grandmother who lived with us and didn't get a lot of support or encouragement. Certainly didn't get any kind of a father figure. I had a couple of adult men that were, you know, those kind of people who were the... You've run into them before in your life, if you're of my age and it was a different generation, people that would look at you and say, no, you're not worthless, you're not insignificant, you're not a nobody. You know, you're somebody, you're unique, you're special, you have some talents, you have some gifts, you have some good qualities, whatever. Things that I didn't really hear from my parents. So maybe when I came out to YouTube, I thought I could do that for other people. You know, maybe I thought I could be that father for some kids or something that I never got myself. Maybe I thought I could be that father figure for some people by providing some kind of support or encouragement or whatever, because it was such a big gaping hole in my own childhood. Not really sure. I've tried to think, why do I bother with this crap? And when I came out with that sentence blurted out, people should be held accountable for how they treat other people. Good heavens. How is that ever going to possibly work in a world like this? How is that a battle you're ever going to win? People should be held accountable. I'm not going to get anybody held accountable for what they do. Maybe, somebody would take notice and hold somebody else accountable for their actions, but there'd be 500 people behind them that would be doing the same thing. I guess I did have a sense, when I was a kid, that I didn't have any value. I wasn't given that kind of encouragement as a child. And, it probably has something to do with some of the low self-esteem that I suffer from, even today, at over 50 years old. I think there's a lot of reasons why people come out to YouTube. And I think the more, I used to think that I was out here to give of myself after a period of time. I mean, when I first came out here, I had no inclination that I had anything to give anybody, part of that scripting. And since then, some people have said that, no, you do have some qualities that are of value. You have some things to give. Okay. But I also think, in my own way, I'm searching for things, searching for some of that acceptance or some of that affirmation that I never got as a child. You are a good person. You are a special person. You're a kind person, whatever. The kinds of things that normal, engaged parents tell their children on a regular basis to build their self-esteem, give them a sense of who they are in the world. So maybe that's part of, what I was doing out here. I guess part of this business just makes me so mad. I get so angry because people exercise power over other people. It's almost like a rape or a molestation kind of thing. I know that's kind of extreme, but that's the way it feels in my heart sometimes. It's like somebody can do and say such ugly things to another person that it infuriates me. And I guess that's where that concept comes from of people should be held accountable for their actions. Like I'm going to hold them accountable, or anybody is even going to bother to hold them accountable. Nobody gets held accountable for much of anything in this world nowadays. So I'm really struggling. I mean, I really appreciate the phone call that I got because it was a very honest phone call. And I'm very receptive to honest feedback, whether it's good or bad. I mean, in the sense of I've got some friends on YouTube or through my experiences on YouTube that will tell me right up front, Tim, I love you to death. But you're poking a stick in a hornet's nest, and the only thing that's going to happen is you're going to get stung real bad. And I respect friends who tell me that I'm screwing up or I'm not thinking about something straight. Injustices in the world. I guess that's, I don't know. Where did I get this sense that there are injustices in the world and they must be stamped out and people should be held accountable? The hell kind of thinking is that nowadays? So I guess part of it too is I'm a little tired. I'm tired of trying to raise awareness of something that seems to be so obviously wrong that something should be done about it. People should be held accountable. And it's crazy, really. I mean, it's really crazy to think that. It's foolish thinking, naive thinking. And there's so much good out here. There's so many great people. You know, so many really cool people and cool channels out here that, you know, perhaps, you know, it's like this person told me, they said, you know, maybe you'd be better served making videos about feeding kids in Africa or something. And he's right. I mean, you know, maybe it's trying to do something positive rather than fight the negative that you're just not going to win against. You know, I mean, there's no win there. It's a negative force. It's there. It's, you know, religious people will tell you it's evil. And it's there. It's in the world. Nothing you can do about it. So, you know, maybe that's the change that I need to think about. Maybe I need to refocus my energies in directions of positive things. And things that could have some benefit from them, rather than trying to rail against the injustices of the world. But I have thought a lot about, you know, my YouTube experience in terms of my own childhood and my own experiences as a child. You know, I wasn't the popular kid in high school. I was really the class clown. That was how I... And you know, when I look back on it, I think I was the class clown because it was a mask, you know, that was easy to put on. I'm the funny guy that sits in the back of the class and makes jokes, and everybody laughs, and everybody thinks I'm funny. You know, when really you're kind of crying inside, and really hurting, you know. And so maybe I did come out here looking for some kind of affirmation or some sense that there could be, you know, some balance in the world. Question of balance, as the Moody Blues would say. We all look for balance in our lives, and I guess we look for the scales to somehow even out. You know, you have bad things happen and you have good things happen, and you hope that they'll even out. I guess too, when you get older and you've got kids that have grown up, you know, they've grown, they're adults, they're gone. I mean, you have an adult relationship with your children, but they're not your little boys anymore, you know? And I guess as a father, and those of you that have children who are grown, I think you can relate to this. You get a sense of, gosh, I did things wrong. You know, there were so many times that I could have been there more. I could have done this differently. I could have done that differently. I could have not got angry that time. I could have been more understanding during that thing, or, you know, whatever. The kinds of things that you beat yourself up as a parent. And maybe that's why we all, you know, sometimes become grandparents, and maybe that's the cycle, you know, so you get kind of a do-over, you know, kind of like, let me try this again, because maybe you feel like you didn't give, you know, that loving affirmation to your children. And so I'm going to do it with my grandkids, you know, make sure they get that. Make sure they get that sense of how special they are. So, as you can tell, I've been doing a lot of introspection, thinking about this whole business and trying to figure out, you know, why is it so important? Why do I continue to stand on the mountaintop screaming at the top of my lungs in the middle of a lightning storm and getting struck repeatedly by lightning and wondering why the hell I feel like I'm on fire and my biscuits are burning and I can't quite figure out why I feel kind of burned up all the time. So I don't know. I don't know. I do think a lot of the stuff that we do out here, a lot of the stuff that happens, you know, is in some way connected to our childhood, whether they were good things or bad things, or whether they were positive experiences or negative. And, you know, you can come out here and maybe try and make up for either deficiencies that you feel you have in yourself, or deficiencies in the way you were treated when you were younger. I don't know, pretty crazy, huh? As you can tell, it's been a kind of a crazy week. I think I'm going to close this out. It was just, I just wanted to share with you some really rambling thoughts, some really just, you know, going all over the place. As Andy would say, just, you know, just turn on the camera and talk. And so that's what I've done. If you've listened to the whole thing, thanks for listening. Talk to you later.